This is Imran Kapadia, and I am representing three world-class institutes which actually form an educational ecosystem. Indian School of Design and Innovation, which is ISDI, which is our foremost school, and at present maybe number 1, 2, 3 in India for design and innovation education. It's been around for 8 years. ISMI, the School of Management and Entrepreneurship, which is about 5 years old, and our newest and youngest school in the field of entertainment and films, which is called DICE VFS School of Entertainment Arts in collaboration with Vancouver Film School, is 2 years old. So I'm representing these three schools today, and happy to be part of this journey. So I don't know whether it was planned or unplanned, but we were always adapted, or we were always inclined towards a CRM. Now what happened is with the number of programs that we offer, with the number of schools that we represent, and with the amount of people who actually represent independent schools and then also move between schools, because we have this huge set of people who work in our various admission teams, not just one, but we've got in fact 4 admissions teams across these three schools who represent different programs. It was always a need. It was the need of the hour. We did not foresee a lockdown scenario when we are actually planning this, but what we wanted is we wanted a single interface where we could have everybody work collaboratively, intuitively also, and at the same time we wanted one platform where we as management could watch what was happening across all teams, so that we could actually pull each other along the way for better performance. When I say better performance, my need was admissions is where the entire business comes from. Even one of the representative from the admissions team, if starts lagging behind on the job, it actually the entire institution suffers. So we didn't want to compromise over there. We wanted to give them the best technologies in the world that was available, and also possibly the world is moving towards a mobile friendly zone. So remote working, mobile working, cloud working, it was all very important for us. So we didn't want them to be restricted to their desk or their offices. We wanted them to be working from anywhere, and luckily we deployed this in 2019, and it took about a full cycle for the team to actually warm up and get used to it, and now become champions at the interface and the system. And now when we are actually working from homes in the last 14 months, it's become very easy for each one of them to do what they are supposed to do and to report in of what is happening. And also the reporting managers, it's become very easy, because even if they don't get a report back from their teams, they exactly know what is happening, because this interface allows them to watch independently each caller, if that is how you want to say it, each caller or each representative of their performances. So it becomes very important. So luckily or strategically, but this actually fell in place during the lockdown. It's a product, or if you call it a service, which is actually available everywhere in the market, and there will be a lot of people who will be offering the same service. A little bit of a dollar here and there per month, per user, up and down is negotiable. But I think the three things that I bought into this system was, one was because of my personal knowing of the promoters of the company. So I actually knew Abhishek since 2014, and I actually have seen the system grow from what it was in 2013-14 to where it is in 2019-20 and now 2021. So I've seen a growth. So I always saw effort invested into the system by the founders, which is very important, because if the founder is not invested enough in the business, then the business doesn't take off from there. So one was the promoter's involvement into the business. Second, what really impressed me was the sales team, which actually came to me, Daksh, who actually came to me, who showed me the interface, who took pains in coming back again and again and doing various demos for various head of departments, admissions teams, right from the top to the bottom of the admissions team. He answered each and every question. He was very, very receptive and available at all point of time to reply to all our queries. And third, and the most important actually, which did seal the deal for me, was customization, because it is not a product which is actually ready, or for example, we are not an organization which actually buys off the shelf. We are an organization which actually buys off the shelf but customizes to our requirement. So we actually were looking at somebody who has a system which is ready, so that we don't have to take the pain of developing a system from scratch, but somebody who could actually customize it to our requirement. I think that played a very important role. The entire technology support, the technical support that came into picture was amazing. Every screen that we actually wanted to customize in the reporting section was done as per our requirement, because it was difficult because we have three senior people who are leading our admissions teams in different programs, and each one of them had a reason to call for a screen which was as per their requirement. So I think the founders, investment from the founders, sales process, the entire onboarding or the negotiation or even being there. And third was the entire, I just felt that, not just from the top of the company, from the top to the bottom of the company, everybody wanted this business, because that is the hunger that we were wanting. Because otherwise we did work with a CRM just before we onboarded actually Extra Edge. And we thought it was just about, they were just interested in selling us the product. That's about it. And then there was no, we had to keep raising tickets, and there was no follow-up after that. So I think this whole process actually gave us confidence that yes, this company is not interested in selling the product to us, but is interested in we using the product. That is what they want. And also, in the course of time, what has happened is that we have grown together as a admissions process, as admission system, and the CRM. We've actually seen some things that is happening on this side, and then we've asked for something that are happening on this side. I think it's become a little bit of a more collaborative, learning from each other, growing with each other, and also making it better, because now this is a product which is not ours or which is not yours, but it is a holistic product which actually grows and we grow together. So I think that these three things were very important for us. People will say that it was cost efficient, it was this and that, but I think I don't think when you look at a product and when you need a product, I don't think cost is even a factor, but I think it's the services that really come into the picture. We're an ecosystem of schools, multiple admissions teams, multiple people. Every head of the admission team actually decided their way of working. So we used some CRMs in the past. We've used Zoho, we've used Pipedrive, we've used HubSpot. We tried a little bit of Salesforce. But what was happening is that it wasn't. We never used a CRM which was completely integrated for all the schools, the entire team together. This time, what we wanted to do is we were very, very heavy on our Excel files. Whereas me being the head of digital engagements at the ecosystem was always keen about having one interface where everybody can actually dump their data, and then where I could actually have a window to see all this. When we actually went ahead and decided to go in for a CRM, there was a little bit of a storm which actually created, because not everybody was comfortable getting out of their comfort zones, because they were very used to Excels. But what Excels did was Excels manipulated a lot of data, because Excels was manually updated. It wasn't organized, it wasn't automated, it wasn't smart, it wasn't responsive. Also, it wasn't available to access every time. So whenever we wanted information or whenever we wanted data, we would have to call the person and then ask him to send data. So we never, as an institute, we were never on a CRM completely. This was the first time when we put in an effort. I'm glad that the effort has been showing results. And also what happens is now everybody's aware that, it is not something that is with them, but it is something which is accessible to everybody else. So there is no cutting corners, there is no shortcuts. If there is a follow-up, that follow-up has to be done. If there is a lead-in from any of my paid sources, they know that the lead-in has come, the lead has to be called, the turnaround time. There are some times when there is a recording available. So there is a lot of check that has been come into place. So a lot of, also what it did was it also allowed us to filter efficient workers, smart workers versus non-performers. So not just in terms of hiring, but also in terms of evaluation of people also made it very easy. I think it is not about standing up once, but it is it is constantly standing, because once you have a customer, you have a customer for your engagement is for a year, right? It's an annual contract that we renew. So the customer support the customer support actually kicks in only when the customer is onboarded. So I've been my testimonial for customer support will be my contract renewal. So my contract has already been renewed, like what I said, from December to now, it's already been a year and a half that we're on. So I think that's testimony enough for a good product with a good customer service or a support team. So anybody out there who's actually shopping or looking for a CRM, I would say before you make a choice, go out and look at all of them, because each one is unique. There is no reason for you to not be looking at everything available, but then make an informed choice like how we did. But what I would vouch for and what I would guarantee is that once you go out and look, and why I said that go out and look for everything is that once you go out and look for everything, you will realize that extra edge actually goes that has that extra edge in it. The name is not just, but it is. I think it is meaningful enough, because they have that edge over everybody else. Product, yes, of course, there will be constant development happening in the product, and that is how the nature of the business is. That's how the world is. But key aspects of the business is something that personal interfacing, the human interface that you get along, is something that I don't really feel that everybody else can offer. So I think it's not for the product. Product is available. I think more or less the same product will be available everywhere else. But I think you should consider this for the other things that come along with the product, which is very human. So I think that is most important.